and welcome to I Heart Gardening. My name is Nadine and today I'm going to review four countertop LED grow lights that I have in my home. I will take you through each unit individually and talk about their pros and cons, as well as go through their operation and give you the prices. The two units on the left are both AeroGarden models, they're a hydroponic system, and the two models on the right are soil-based, so they're just a light system. If you're looking to get into some indoor gardening and looking for some help and deciding which kind of countertop model you would like to buy, hopefully this will give you some good information and help you get started. So this is the AeroGarden Harvest Plus model. I've had this one for about 2 years and I've grown about four different crops with it. What I have growing in here is on the left, I've got two pods there with a leaf lettuce, and on the right, I've got two pods there planted up with arugula. I bought a Grow Anything seed kit. So the pods are the plastic things that have a sponge growing medium in them. And it comes with a bottle of fertilizer. You need to add your own seeds to that. And so far, I have found that lettuce does well, and the herbs that come with the original kit have done well. I've also tried their mini tomato. I will say for that one, the tomatoes were quite small and kind of not really worth growing. I have tried spinach and cilantro in there as well, and those two crops did not do very well for me. So this lettuce and arugula, I planted just 2 weeks ago, so maybe 15, 16 days. And I have a message here flashing for me telling me to add nutrients. So I'll go ahead and add the nutrients and show you how that's done. So from the nutrients that AeroGarden provides, you just add a capful inside. And then once that's done, you hit OK, and that resets the nutrient timer. And this has a menu button, so you can select the type of crop that you're growing here. Here, 16 days planted. So that's pretty good results for 16 days. And I have this set plant select. So you can select salads, which I have going in here. So it'll automatically keep the light on for 16 and a half hours. Or if you selected herbs, the light would be on for 17 hours. Or you could set it for whatever you wanted. When I bought it 2 years ago, I paid $120 for it on sale. So really the only negative thing I have to say about this is the price. So the initial price is not bad if you can find one on sale. But then when you're buying your additional seed pods, each one of these seed pods kits is approximately $20. So I try to reuse these plastic seed pods whenever I can to try to get a little bit more value out of this. And just one other little thing I'll show you, like this is a 6-pod model, but I've only got 4 seed pods planted. So I do have some little caps to cover that came with the tomato seed kit, because you only get 2 seed pods with the tomato seed kit. And the grow light is adjustable, so you adjust it with the height of your plants. So when your plants are small, you can push the light down so they get more light. And as your plants grow, you can raise it up. And it really is just simple pulling up and down. There's no buttons or anything you need to press. And then the bowl is where you fill with water. So that's the hydroponics part of it, is that these are actually growing in water. And then if I lift this up, I can show you the roots. You can see how those plants have a really good root system. That's my little plastic cap. I'll find that later. And then I think the last thing I wanted to show you is the versatility of these aero gardens, is that you don't have to use it with the water bowl. If you wanted to, you could take the water bowl off and just use the LED grow light. So all you do, there's a cord at the back, you just unhook and you can take the bowl right off. And if you wanted to, you could place another plant or two on top of there. I don't know if you can hear that sound, but you can actually hear the pump running. I forgot to mention that there is a pump and it circulates the water in there. And this unit will tell you when you need to add water, but you'll get to know the sound of the pump and you'll be able to hear when you need to add water because that sound gets louder. And then I just wanted to mention too that I said I like to try to reuse these seed pods, but sometimes you won't be able to because the roots will just be too massive and you won't be able to cut them out from the sponge. And it's actually the sponge that you won't be able to reuse. This is my new aero garden harvest. I bought this one just a couple of weeks ago at Canadian Tire for $100. I've got this one planted up at the same time as I planted up my other aero garden. So you can see that the herbs are a little bit smaller. So I'm thinking it just took a little bit longer for them to germinate, but I think they'll grow no problem. I grew these herb seeds before and they grew big, no problem. So this is the 6-pack of herbs that comes with the new model when you purchase it. And I've got curly parsley, dill, mint, Thai basil, Genovese basil, and thyme. This model operates more or less the same as the previous model, but just a couple of small differences to show you. One is the fertilizer port. When you take this one out, it's a hard plastic, so it fits a little bit nicer than the other one. The old one, the plastic is softer and it's warped a little bit. And then it's got a simplified display on the bottom, so rather than having to scroll through a menu, this one shows you with the buttons that are lit up. So the green one is for adding plant food, the blue one is for adding water, and the white one is for the light. And you can see that it's really quite bright. So I'm just going to turn it back off for now so you can actually see it. And when you need to add water or fertilizer, the lights will actually turn red, so then you'll know. And the other little small difference is there's a button at the back, and that's how you raise and lower the grow light. But other than that, it works great, just like the other one. I recommend them, and I think they're a great way to get started with your indoor gardening. The light on this one is automatic as well. I think it's set for 15 hours automatically. And in order to set it for when you want the light to go on, you just hold it for 3 seconds. And you'll see it flashing. So now it's programmed to start exactly now with the 15 hours on. This is my third LED grow light. This one's a lot simpler in design. Basically just an LED light that moves up and down on a stand. There is a tray at the bottom. It has automatic on off light. You just plug it in and it turns on for its approximately 15 hours. It does have a manual switch if you want to turn the light on. The switch is located inside the cord. It's pretty simple operation for the light up and down. There's a screw knob at the back. I've had this one for a few months. I think I paid $60 for it at Lee Valley. I'm not sure the brand name. There's nothing actually written on the box, but I have seen them on Amazon as well, so I'll include some pictures of what the box looks like. Other than that, so far I'm pretty happy with it. I like it. I think the light's doing a pretty good job with the plants, and I think it's actually kind of cute. And here's what the back of it looks like. This is the screw knob here to adjust the light. You just twist it there, whoops, and you can move it down and then screw the knob back in. And it holds fairly well. It's pretty sturdy. This is my fourth indoor LED grow light. It's a countertop just like the other ones. This one's a little bit different in that it is, or was actually, a self-watering system as well. I've got the two little pots raised up here, and what's underneath is just a platform that raises up higher, and originally came with a wicking mat that would go over top and evenly disperse water. I ended up not liking the wicking mat at all. I found my plants were overwatered and had fungus gnat problems. Also, the wicking mat got moldy and green and it grossed me out, so eventually I just threw it out. So now I have the two pots up on stands just because I need to raise them a little bit closer to the light because the green onion's too tall. So this one did come with four pots, and it is a soil-based system, so there is potential for fungus gnat problems here, but with soil, at least you can grow something like green onions that you wouldn't be able to do in a hydroponic system. So this unit is a Sunblaster Grow Light Garden. I bought it at Lee Valley for $145 about a year and a half ago. It's okay, not my favorite. It does have adjustable height for the light, but you have to turn both knobs in order to move it up and down, and that can actually kind of get awkward. It does not have an automatic light on-off system like the other three did, so I have to keep this one on a timer. It does have a manual switch if you wanted to turn it on and off yourself. Here is the lettuce. I have the same lettuce growing in this pot as I do in the Arrow Garden, and you can see the results difference. In the Arrow Garden, the lettuce is doing much better. All four models here I have purchased in store, but there are additional models to suit your needs online. And these things are just great if you're getting started with gardening, particularly the Arrow Gardens, because they come with everything you need. They're automated, they do all the work for you, they tell you what you need to do and when you need to do it. So even if you don't have a green thumb, you can grow with an Arrow Garden. Thanks for joining me today. Happy growing.